Remember the service here this morning. The memorial behind me contains 64 names of men from Mullaghlin who lost their lives serving in the military during World War I. At the Mullaghlin Church, there's a memorial with the names of 107 men and women, also from the parish, who lost their lives serving during World War I. I think it was so easy just to look at names and forget the impact that the death of each of these brave men and women had, not just on their families, but also in this community, and not just at the time, but for generations to follow. So as we gather here today, we don't just want to remember, but we also want to say thank you. Thank you to the men and women from this community, and thank you to the millions of people who gave their lives, not just in World War I, but also in the countless wars and conflicts which have followed, some of which are still being fought today. We want to remember and say thank you to all the brave men and women who give up their lives and freedom so that we can enjoy ours. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, as time passes by, it's so easy to forget. Help us to remember with clear eyes the horrific cost of war. Help us to remember with deep sorrow those who killed and were killed. Help us to remember with grief the bloodstained battlefields. Help us to remember with compassion the bereaved and the wounded. Help us to remember with respect those who risk their lives for peace. Help us to remember family members, friends, and people of all walks of life who courageously and faithfully serve or have served in the armed forces. And help us never to forget that Jesus made the ultimate sacrifice for each and every one of us so that we can be free. In the mighty name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Let's join together in our first hymn, O God, our help in ages past. Father is glorified that you bear much fruit, so you will be my disciples. As the Father loved me, I also have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. These things I have spoken to you, that my joy may remain in you, and that your joy may be full. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Greater love is no one than this, than to lay down one's life for his friends. You are my friends, you do whatever I command you. No longer do I call you servants, for a servant does not know what his master is doing. But I have called you friends. For all things that I heard from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I choose you, and appointed you that you should go and bear fruit, and that your fruit should remain, that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. These things I command you, that you love one another.
Hurry! Hurry! Done!
They shall grow not old, as we their neck grow old. The age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
When you go home, tell them of us and say, your tomorrow we give our today.
Join the gallery now for our final hymn. I beg with me.
Abide with me.
Remembrance, we weep for the waste that war brings. We pray for those who still bear the pain and the scars. And we remember with thanks those who have given their lives so that we may live in freedom. Bring near the day when war shall cease and poverty and pain shall end, that the earth may know the peace of heaven through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And let us join together in the national anthem.
Standard bears!
One, four.